Ladies and gentlemen, I have to do this particular video over. I finished the video.
And I can't believe it, y'all. The gentleman that was here, ladies and gents, I recorded over the video by mistake.
Mariah Carey. And she is singing what she believes. And after all this time, ladies and gentlemen, Mariah Carey, and she's talking about that she still believes. Ladies and gentlemen, there are many of you who are going through foreclosure, whether it is on an automobile, a student loan, a credit card, pay attention, or a home loan. I want you all to understand something. That little piece of paper, that little stupid statement of accounting that these idiots give you, that's not evidence of no debt. And you don't have to accept that. Ladies and gentlemen, if you pay attention to the information here, I put this conversation here for you guys. See, we started the conversation out this way. I said that merely providing a line of credit didn't automatically constitute funding. Each of you have a Truth in Lending Act statement. Grab your Truth in Lending Act statement. That's the best evidence in the world. You keep hearing me shout it and scream it. It's the best evidence in the world you could possibly have, because that shows that they loaned you credit. Those little boxes that are at the top, it says the credit that was given to you. On your behalf, you received credit. Well, just giving you a line of credit doesn't constitute funding. You were promised funding. Oh, you're loan funded. We can sign the closing docs now. They promised you funding. All of you have heard that word funding if you've had any type of a loan given to you. Well, we're waiting for the loan to fund. If you dealt with a real estate agent, you've heard the word funding. Well, ladies and gentlemen, they promised you funding, and they didn't provide funding. Hey, I got to take this call. This is a consultant. One second. Ladies and gentlemen, it has been about maybe 4 hours since I started this video. 3 hours, don't care, don't matter, just tired. A lot of calls, a lot of people who's got some situations and been talking and helping them, and we've been doing some meetings with trading. So let's get back to this so that you guys will understand. Many of you have these mortgages. Many of you are told you owe money on these mortgages. What you have the right is to demand an accounting and see proof that they funded the account. They told you they funded the account, so you have the right to demand that they provide proof that they funded the account. Just sending you an account statement is not good enough. The account statement is not signed by anyone. So merely providing a line of credit doesn't automatically constitute funding, requiring the creditor to prove by evidence actual advances of funds under the line to substantiate under the line of credit so that they funded the account to substantiate their claim. It is a legal principle derived from cases such as these. The principle suggests that simply offering a line of credit does not necessarily mean that the funds have been provided to you, and the creditor must demonstrate actual disbursement of funds under the line of credit to support their argument. The legal principle is important. This legal principle is important in the context of providing the existence of funding in a bankruptcy or other legal proceeding. It highlights the distinction between the mere ability of credit availability and the actual provision of the funds, giving you the funds, placing the burden of proof on the creditor to establish that funds were indeed advanced. Ladies and gentlemen, Then they give us the cases. Hold on now. Gotta make sure y'all understand. I took these cases and I threw it back at the system. The principle of line of credit alone does not constitute funding. Requiring a creditor to prove actual advances is supported by these cases, and we confirmed these cases. Did you know that providing a mere statement of accounting on a bankruptcy record does not qualify as evidence under the rules of evidence for state and federal courts? Hold on one second. There truly must be something special and important about this particular video, because this one has taken forever to get completed, but we're going to get it done. Ladies and gentlemen, for those of you who don't understand and who need to understand what's going on, when they introduce a statement of accounting after you've asked them for accounting, the statement of accounting must be proof of the accounting. It can't just be some numbers printed on a piece of paper. Let's do this. When they introduce that into the court, you must be challenging that record. Look, this is the information that was asked. Did you know that providing a mere statement of accounting on a bankruptcy record does not qualify as evidence under the rules of evidence for state courts or federal courts? Here's the answer. Providing a mere statement of accounting on a bankruptcy record does not qualify as evidence under the rules of evidence for state courts or federal courts. The federal court rules of evidence, including rules 43, 44, and 44.1, why don't you just say 44, moron? Anyway, of the Federal Rules of Civil Procedure, apply to cases under the bankruptcy code, and they govern the admission of exclusion of evidence in most proceedings in the United States courts. In other words, state courts and federal courts. It's a unified court system, people. Additionally, the bankruptcy rules in official forms require specific evidence and documentation to be provided in bankruptcy proceedings, such as proof of claims. They can't just say, oh, we got a claim, Your Honor. You need to prove that there's a claim, an actual claim. A promissory note does not prove a claim because it does not prove that the debt has not already been paid for. Therefore, a mere statement of accounting would not meet the evidentiary standards required in bankruptcy proceedings. Now, what's the difference between a statement of accounting and evidence in a bankruptcy proceeding? Ladies and gentlemen, a statement of accounting is not evidence. In a bankruptcy case, a statement of accounting and evidence serve different purposes. A statement of accounting typically provides detailed account of a debtor's financial situation, including assets, liabilities. This is what you provide the bankruptcy court. However, remember, you must sign that, and is often part of the disclosure statement and the plan for reorganization. On the other hand, evidence in a bankruptcy case refers to information or documentation presented to the bankruptcy court supporting a party's claims, objection, or defenses. This evidence is subject to the rules of evidence and must meet the relevant legal standards for the admission and relevance in bankruptcy proceedings. So just providing a simple statement is not evidence. That's because the attorneys, as being officers of the court whom you guys hire, will never bring this stuff up because they are precluded by law from bringing up this stuff. So you have to do it. Let's continue. While a statement of accounting offers a comprehensive overview of the debtor's financial position, it does not automatically qualify as admission of evidence under the rules of evidence for state and federal courts. Evidence in a bankruptcy case may adhere to applicable rules and be presented in accordance with the legal requirements governing the admission of evidence in such proceedings. Therefore, while a statement of accounting provides financial information, it does not inherently constitute evidence unless it is properly introduced and accepted as such within the bankruptcy proceeding. You must challenge your statement of accounting. Ladies and gentlemen, we do it every single turn. Why? Because we're setting our clients for the kill. We're letting them go into bankruptcy court with the proof that we've challenged the evidence. Then this is what is evidence in a bankruptcy proceeding. Ladies and gentlemen, the cases that we put in here showing that a statement of accounting and a mere claim is not enough. That if they loaned you credit, which all of you who have a Truth in Lending Act statement, whether you are a student loan, home loan, or car loan. You have a truth in lending act statement. Why did they give you a truth in lending act statement? Truth in lending act statement is required because they gave you credit. It's not required if they gave you money. Go ahead, pay attention. That's why it's truth in lending. They have to provide it to you to show that they loaned you credit, not money. But when they told you your account funded, they now need to show proof of those funds. That's where Federal Reserve Act, Section 16, 1 and 2, paragraphs 1 and 2, that's where that comes in at. Because the Federal Reserve, the funding comes from the Federal Reserve Board of Governors. They never funded your account, people. That's how they don't win, they lose. So you guys will be getting a copy of this link. We'll be coming shortly. We'll talk to you guys soon. Take care of yourselves. Gotta go, gotta go, gotta go.